Do modern scientific discoveries about the origin of the universe and humans support or contradict the biblical record? Did the modern scientific method develop out of a Christian worldview, or does a Christian mindset impede scientific advancement? Is science a friend or foe of biblical Christianity? The answer to these types of questions are of vital importance to both believers and non-believers, for they influence our understanding of God's character and His revelation to us. I'm Mike Strauss, one of the four presenters in this series on an introduction to Christianity and science. As a physics professor at a public university, I've talked with many Christian students who are struggling with their faith because they perceive an apparent conflict between the scientific facts they are learning in school and the message of the Bible. I also know Christians who simply avoid any apparent conflict by compartmentalizing and separating their Christian beliefs from their beliefs about scientific conclusions. I've talked with many non-believers who will not even consider Christianity as a valid worldview because of their misunderstanding about biblical teaching and its relationship to scientific discovery. In our modern scientific and technical world, it is crucial that Christians have a reasonable understanding of the various subjects that intersect science and Christianity. We need to have a broad knowledge of the dialogue that has developed between scientific and Christian thought, as well as between Christians with divergent views on controversial issues. This series is designed to help navigate through the many aspects of this often polarizing, confusing, and complicated topic of the intersection between science and Christianity. The sessions are based on over 450 articles written by more than 140 leading evangelical experts and compiled in print in the Zondervan Dictionary of Christianity and Science. Over the next 13 sessions, the other three presenters and I will take you on a journey through the intersection of Christianity and science and present a synthesis of some major topics. In each session, one or two of us will examine a major theme, summarizing material contained in the book by the many different contributing scholars and sharing additional personal thoughts and insights. Let me briefly introduce each of our four presenters. Paul Copan earned his PhD in philosophy from Marquette University. He is currently the Pledger Family Chair of Philosophy and Ethics at Palm Beach Atlantic University in West Palm Beach, Florida. In addition to authoring many journal articles, he's written or edited over 30 books in philosophy, theology, and apologetics, and has served as the president of the Evangelical Philosophical Society. Tremper Longman III received his PhD from Yale University in Ancient Near East Studies. He's a distinguished scholar and professor emeritus of biblical studies at Westmont College in Santa Barbara, California. He's on the advisory council of the BioLogos Foundation, the Old Testament editor for the Revised Expositor's Bible Commentary, a general editor for the Story of God Bible Commentary Old Testament, and has authored many articles and books on the Psalms and other Old Testament books. Christopher L. Reese has a Master of Divinity degree from Beeson Divinity School and a Master of Theology degree from Talbot School of Theology. He's a writer, editor, and publishing professional. He co-founded the Christian Apologetics Alliance and is a general editor, along with Paul Copan, on the Zondervan book, Three Views on Christianity and Science. I received my bachelor's degree from Biola University and my PhD in physics from UCLA. I'm currently a David Ross Boyd Professor of Physics at the University of Oklahoma in Norman. I conduct research in experimental particle physics, studying the fundamental particles and forces in the universe using data from the Large Hadron Collider at CERN in Geneva, Switzerland. I've previously done research at both the Stanford Linear Accelerator and the Fermi National Accelerator Laboratory. When I'm not doing research or teaching, I speak at churches, schools, and universities around the world about the intersection of science and Christianity. These sessions are designed to give you a broad overview, as well as some deeper insight into some of the most important, interesting, and even controversial topics regarding the intersection of Christian faith and contemporary science. Each of the 13 subsequent sessions will focus on one of the major themes that encompasses this extensive subject. These sessions will present a comprehensive summary of the historical development of science in the Western world, various ideas about genesis and its relationship to modern science, a discussion of philosophy of science and Christian faith, a look at evolution, intelligent design, and the biblical text, a survey of key individuals who've shaped the science-faith dialogue, an examination of ethical issues that touch on science and faith, and an overview of different models for relating Christianity and science, and finally a description of current and future scientific theories and their overlap with biblical ideas. We believe that a frank dialogue about these topics will bring much-needed light on a subject that is often fraught with heated dialogue and little productive insight. Our hope is that you will come away with a broader understanding of how science and biblical Christianity intersect that will serve to strengthen your faith and to provide some deeper insight that will in turn be useful in your dialogue with believers and non-believers. We're confident that a better understanding of the intersection of science and Christianity will ultimately lead to a better understanding of God Himself. I have a friend who is an accomplished painter and artist. He says that when you look at a piece of art, you see the soul of the artist. This universe is God's artwork, and we should expect to see His soul when we explore its mysteries. Paul made such a claim in Romans 1:20, where he wrote that God's invisible qualities, His eternal power and divine nature, have been clearly seen, being understood from what has been made so that people are without excuse. Scientific inquiry, by its very nature, investigates God's handiwork. We should expect that both the special revelation in the Bible and the general revelation in nature will present a consistent picture of His character. We are excited about the opportunity to explore the intersection of science and Christianity with you and get a deeper understanding of God as He is revealed through His created works and His written words. This should be an inspiring and fulfilling journey together.